Remember this. I got you.
They what? They killed the Lord Jesus. They persecuted us. They please not God. They're contrary to all men. They clash with everyone.
What do you think about the future of our country? Are you alarmed about the increased crime rate in all of our cities?
This country is built on total aggression. There was room for everyone.
I need some get back.
But now he owns everything.
This land, in this place, with these people, we're going to take our country back again. It's 1776. God bless you and God bless America.
But tell me, I mean, you're going to get even with some people.
If somebody was out to hurt you, if somebody was out to do a number on you, I really believe that you should just do a number on them if you get the chance.
Turn off your televisions, turn on your podcasts, load up your Bitcoin wallet. We're getting ready for the next century.
Let me hit him.
Hey, wait, come back.
Let's do this.
It's like putting on an old pair of boots you've worn so many times before, even though many of you genetically have never physically done it in this lifetime. But your guts have done it. Your genetics have done it. Your family history, your earth suit, it's made up of all your ancestors. Not the incarnation or reincarnation they talked about. Your soul's new, your soul's original, your soul's in this body. But the body, he is your family. How cool is God? Who could come up with that? So awesome, man. Our bodysuit is all of our ancestors and their memories. That's like heads-up display. Way cooler than the internet, man.
It's only just begun.
Yeah.
Now you know why you all say it, idiots.
Who could come up with that? That's awesome.
I mean, it's so cool. Yeah, that's why Jones is the king, dude. I searched far and wide on my phone for that thing.
No, I mean, I've been looking online, and that's been in your phone the whole time. I believe you owe me an apology.
You know, we don't want to go back to pictures from February and videos of February 2019.
Oh, right.
That's happy making times.
Yeah. I forgot her.
That's happy making times. We just want to, you know,
go have for it. Fun. Push on through.
Lynn Wood, so cool. Freaking Cindy Powell, so cool. Why do we want to look at videos when I was in Mexico?
The best years are ahead of you, man.
Why do I want to look at videos in Mexico?
It's okay, man. It's all right.
I'm just
you have
here.
A tough time.
I'm just time. Here to have fun.
It's cool that you can crack it, though. You finally went back in your phone. You get scared of your past. You finally broke through. You're like, enough time. It's been enough time.
Yeah, this is.
I can see it. I can see it.
Yeah, I went through that. I have a lot of incriminating videos on my phone, dude.
How do you mean?
Just like shit I screenshot. Like, there's certain shit I screen record and screenshot that, like, to the normal person, they would just be like,
oh,
why is this screen recorded? Why is this funny?
My photos alone would get me jail time.
Yeah, I mean,
I'm talking of pictures I've taken of people and send to you. Yeah. Can you believe this? Oh my God.
Yeah, I mean, literally Saturday, there was a dude.
I'm a demon.
There was a dude crossing the street, and like, I constantly think about just trying to explain it to a normal person. It was a dude just like a pot belly trendy with his fucking, what do you call
got
it?
A mustache?
No, he had a mask on that was rainbow. And then what are the things you put over the strap over your shoulder and then the bag?
Yes, whatever. Indiana Jones type.
But the whole thing was like a floral paisley thing.
Yeah.
And just walking with the straightest knees, like knees barely bend when he's stepping. Just a weird dude. And I took a picture of him, obviously. And in the picture to my group chat, I said, what happened to the current state of the white man? And like, there's no explaining that. If someone read that, I was like, dude, are you in the Ku Klux Klan? Like, no, yeah. It's just funny. That's funny to joke around about. Like having fun.
Okay. Yeah. I mean, okay.
That's where I'm at, dude.
You like to make fun of the way people look.
not the like that whole like get up and that stuff. You know they're doing that for a reason
because that's just a their lot. Style.
That's
dude.
So much, dude.
But like that's their they feel comfortable in that skin.
Cut it out.
If you respawned in that skin, you'd fucking ice yourself.
Yeah, I probably would commit, dude.
Yeah.
But yeah, I mean, the coolest man on the planet currently to me is Lynn Wood. I didn't know that was Lynn Wood, dude. That him sitting up on stage with his MAGA hat, dude, that is the most powerful man in the country.
Is he the dude that I was thinking from the...
No, okay. I think that's just a pastor.
They sound the same.
Yeah, the guys who are saying we're going to do it God's way.
Yeah.
Yeah, dude, did you see the...
I just saw the clip you sent me and some of the video.
That was wild, dude. They're freaking the fuck out. It's like confusing that people are still sitting there like, oh, they got caught because they're Q-tards. It's like, dude, they know like the hot, like Sidney Powell is a military lawyer. She's not getting tricked by memes.
Yeah.
Like, I don't know.
Saying it's like more insidious. Like she's part of it. She's part of like a paid psyop.
Yeah. That's me. I'm killing myself if that happens.
I mean, it wouldn't be the first time. That's how psychological warfare works. But I mean, hey, dude, sometimes you trick me.
If mommy Kraken does
sometimes
that to
I me. Like to be tricked by mommy Kraken.
She does that to me. I'm going to have to commit. Yeah. Dude, I was watching the shit they're doing in California. It's disgusting.
What?
They're trying to make you, if you want to put up Christmas lights, get a permit.
Don't tell me that they're going against Christmas, man.
If you want to put them up, get a permit.
You know who doesn't like Christmas.
If you want to, you can.
I get fired up.
If you want to put up Christmas lights, permit first.
Too much government, man.
That I mean, Gavin Newsom, what is he, the nephew to Pelosi?
Yeah, they're all related, which was weird. They're all like this, like top four families of California.
Oh, yeah. It's like
it's like gangster stuff.
I feel like it all is.
I know, but I mean, it's like that's blatant. I don't know who's in charge of Pennsylvania.
Yeah, I mean,
you know what I mean.
Yeah, they're shut. There was a video of a chick they shut down her outdoor seating.
I saw that. I was fucked.
And it's like the movie people
made
can
no
do that.
Sense, dude. Well, obviously Hollywood, dude. They're like a gang.
I don't know how people haven't went on a fucking rampage. I don't know how if you don't see that. If I was that girl. I know we live in a litigious country, but I'd start Jesus flipping tables. All those tables would be upside down. All those tents would be down.
Dude, the New York Times is having an article saying regular immunity you get from this virus isn't good. You need the vaccine. So, like, this doesn't play by any of the rules of regular viruses.
I mean, I already got torched for being a straight retard on Matt Chains.
Oh, really?
Like, yeah. Like, imagine thinking.
Yeah, fried.
Imagine
thinking. I don't know. I didn't even watch it.
Yeah. You did.
I don't even listen to this guy.
Imagine thinking that this will be bad for you. It's like, dude, just look at who's behind it. It's not. It's definitely not going to be beneficial to you. Like Shane thinking that the government is just rolling this out and you can't sue them because it's better for them.
Yeah, I laugh.
Shane's a white supremacist and he exposes himself.
He doesn't have a lot to say to me.
Because you're short and sneaky. It's not all short people, dude.
Yeah, it's not. Yeah.
It isn't.
Uh-huh.
You're a cool guy for being
short. I'm trying to make friends, okay? And I'm a little paranoid, I'm a little weird.
You're cool all for right. a short guy. I trust you.
But, like, to think that I would have to, like, trick. You know what? It's just a reminder that I don't deserve love.
Yes.
Because I can't protect her.
Yeah, she wants to feel comfortable.
If you want to feel protected.
And protected.
And safe from, yes. I guess, 6'2" alcoholics. I don't know. I don't know who's out there.
Yeah.
But, I mean, I'm trying to make friends. Some other guys are trying to. They're experimenting with blue-collar friends. And that's fine. And and that's fine.
You were hurt. I'm sure he didn't mean it. He was just talking about Keith Raniere.
Chris O'Connor. Shane, I mean, they say some stuff. I'm a little sensitive. I'm always on mushrooms. I'm broke.
Yeah.
It's tough.
Yeah.
You know, I'm sitting here. Oh, man, I'm going to get some. Oh, yeah, don't have any money. You know, maybe you had to consult the Talmud before you released the Patreon fund.
I'm waiting for it to go through.
Maybe I didn't.
Calm down.
I didn't.
Yeah, calm down.
Did
now,
I break
down.
Some of the Noahide rules, dude? Like,
no, calm
what's going
down.
On, man?
Now, calm down. No one's
getting me fired up straight off the bat here, dude.
No, they're stealing Christmas. Let's focus on
that. You know, I had a rough couple of days. Now you're telling me they're stealing Christmas.
Well, you can get a permit to put the lights up. That's fair.
I don't live in California, dude. I never would.
Yeah. I can tell. It's just crazy that it's like it's weird. Like you were saying about Wolf, like somebody has some sort of picture. Gavin Newsom entering an animal, something.
The thing with Schiff, remember that conspiracy with Schiff where he was like, he fucked a dead black kid in the Chateau Marmont or whatever?
The same hotel that Hunter Biden's pictures were geotagged.
That might be fake, but.
Same place Anthony Bourdain killed himself.
I mean, maybe this is where they go. Maybe this is what they do. Maybe Wolf did this.
I mean,
maybe Cuomo did this. You know what I mean?
To be that out in the open, like. Crazy biased to let the Hollywood people have their outdoor eating because they have to make a fucking meaningless movie. That is so dumb.
We're done with them. We don't need them anymore. We made all the movies, dude.
Let the Pineapple Grill open up, dude. Let the Pineapple Grill have its outdoor seating.
For real, man.
Let her and her milkers do whatever they want.
You know, I'm painting and the lady that I'm painting for is a teacher. And I'm hearing these kids trying to learn how to read on Zoom. I mean, hey, dude, these guys are in the lowest reading group.
Not happening.
Not happening, bro.
The only thing
us track three kids, dude, trying to get through the first couple years of school, not online, man. That's not happening.
The only thing that could keep me online when I was little, Tonka had a video game, and that's it. There was a computer Tonka game. That's
A SimCity type thing?
If you wanted me to sit there and try to learn on the computer, dude, I'm done.
Yeah, you're fried. You're at your house. You're getting snacks.
You can hear your brothers and sisters gooming.
Yeah, taking a million bathroom breaks. Oh, the gooming, for real. Cold War. Hey, man. Take it easy, guys. Gooming all high school kids. Gooming all day. Not in school at all.
Yeah, I mean, it is going to be wild to see how these fuckers develop. Because, like, this is, like...
For what? You know what I mean? For fucking what, dude?
Oh, fucking bad virus that... Now, let me tell you this. Let me educate your stupid fucking ass, dude. The reason flu deaths are down... are because people are
wearing... I wonder if I'm dumb because I'm short. That might be a thing, too.
Definitely a possibility. The reason flu deaths are down is because people wear masks, and the masks protect you from the flu, but not as good with the coronavirus.
It doesn't give you fungal pneumonia?
No.
Okay. Cool.
Ventilators help you breathe.
Ventilators don't definitely give you pneumonia because they're stored in a storage facility in the dark. They don't have funguses that give you pneumonia at all.
Dude, they get sterilized.
Dude, I was talking to Fed about this. Do you remember New York? They had... the demo job where they all freaked out because the fungus was in the building.
Oh, the flesh-eating fungus?
Yeah, remember that, dude? Well, I mean, what if you have these things in storage and there's these weird funguses we don't even know about?
Yeah.
And then you put these people on ventilators. The thing's been chilling.
Mm-hmm.
You know?
Yeah, there's a lot of sorcery afoot with everything. It's a very weird thing, like Cuomo getting the Emmy and stuff, and like this dude knowingly putting...
He put on the dress, basically, with those nipple rings.
Yeah.
He basically put on the dress.
He's a pervert.
I don't know what he did, dude.
Yeah, I mean,
him and his brother are fucking freak shows. His dad was greasy as fuck.
Really?
Yeah, his dad was like an old school Democrat.
Oh, Jesus.
They were a politician family, dude.
It literally just doesn't make any sense. And I catch heat for saying, like, oh, they're not reporting flu deaths. But, like, dude, if you look at the overall deaths, everything's down. And that's – you can't just say, well, that's because –
that's because we're locked down. We're not doing anything.
Yeah, you can't say that.
But I just did.
People still eat. People still Grubhubbing. People are still getting caviar. People are still getting a burger and a milkshake mixed into one.
The video with the lady that had the picnic table thing set up, you know, the Hollywood thing.
Yeah.
I went into this a peasant, so I don't have to worry about a ton of shit. Like, mm-hmm. I just have to buy paint and eat.
Yeah.
Imagine if you go into this with, like, overhead.
All the debt, yeah.
Oh, my God, dude. Like, that is suey time.
Yeah. And suicide's up. I mean, at what point do these people from restaurants just say enough is enough and fucking...
Yeah, I mean, there's not going to be any restaurants anymore.
That's what I'm saying. Like, why would you just lie and, like, sit there and let them walk all over you?
They won't survive the Great Reset anyway. Any cash business is just going to disappear once they go into this CBDC thing. Once they go into the digital coinage...
Yeah.
You're not going to be able to have some weird business where you're living like a king, paying waitresses $2 an hour.
Mm-hmm.
That's over, bro.
Yeah, it is weird that they're just gunning for this. Like, the World Economic Forum's releasing more and more podcasts. Like, why the fuck do we ever have to hear from the World Economic Forum? Like,
Klaus.
Yeah, Klaus Schwab, dude, whatever his fucking name is.
Yeah, dude, they're not going to survive. I wonder if we were living in, like, the roaring 20s already.
I think.
You know what I mean? Like, we were living high on the hog, like, streaming, everything being free, we're chilling.
Yeah.
We're go out to eat. We're living in a free country, all this shit. And then they're like, oh, boom, America, you're going to be a debtor nation, and here's your digital currency. I mean, we're back. We're game over at that point, dude. We're like.
Yeah. I was thinking about that all week. Like, if this is like the World War II era, and it's like, ah, man, I just got fucked this go around. I'll wait till the next reincarnation, see how it goes for me.
Yeah, dude. I mean, my Ursuit got me ready for this somehow. I don't know how, but I mean, I've been chilling. I got myself set up pretty nice for a global pandemic, used to being alone. Yeah. I'm ready to go.
Yeah, you're ready for the apocalypse, honestly. Yeah, it was crazy. This, like, when I said that shit on Matt and Shane, just like normal stuff we all talk right, about
dude,
all the time.
We get it. You're famous. You go on other podcasts. I get it, dude.
They woke me up, walked upstairs. This is my house.
I get it, dude.
Like, the fucking weird hate you get. And then
you don't like it. No, you don't the comments.
I'm saying for like coronavirus and stuff like that, because I'll say something, and if I say where I got it, like, oh, well, I watched a YouTube video. I got it on the internet. And it's like, no, that's wrong. I just looked it up, and you're wrong. I was like, okay, so my internet's wrong, and your internet's right.
It's like when you get hit with a link to prove how dumb you are from, like, Abe Foxman.
Yeah.
Thanks, man.
I don't get the, like, disconnect where, like, anything
you're like, hold on, Spade's so dumb. Let me show him.
Yeah. It's like, okay, where can I obtain the right internet? Because currently I'm on the wrong internet, and I don't know how to fix it. Because everything you look up proves me wrong on the internet.
The only thing that pisses me off with that stuff is there's a weird attitude against believing that there's an elite pedophile ring. There's a weird aggressive,
it's also
like,
a huge push for making it normal.
No, I'm talking about, like, regular people.
Yeah, they laugh at it.
Not only do they laugh at it, like, they get mad at you for, like, believing it. And, like, they try to project that, like, you're obsessed with it or something.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
And I'm like, yeah, but, dude, like, were you cool with, when you heard that the Catholic Church was doing this, did you have the same reaction? Because I'm assuming it's a little close to home when it comes to Hollywood.
You don't talk about close to home, bro?
What?
Didn't I tell you?
What are you talking about?
Oh, I hung up before I said. My principal at Salesianum, he left junior year, like, abruptly. Junior,
oh my god, you
got
touched?
No. Father Bill. The word just got out that he went over to Monaco, did some, like, whatever, but just got obliterated with CP. Dude was a CP monster. He was like a hip young priest. Funniest part was he went over to my aunt and uncle's house, 1002, all those boys, all the blonde hair, beautiful boys, and he would do personal masses for them.
What, dude? Yeah,
all the time.
When was this? This is after me.
That's after you.
Okay, yeah, I'm clear.
Hold your horses. So I send this to the group text to everyone who went to Sally's in my family. And Joey just goes, dude, what the fuck? He just goes, I remember that dude asked. Mind you, Joey was probably about, this is when their grandma died, a while back. Joey's probably like 10. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
Father Bill's doing a personal mass. And asked Joey, a 10-year-old, let me get a bite of your bagel.
Like, oh, ooh, dude.
Joe.
Come on.
What the fuck?
Just a little kiss.
What a sweet little morsel that must have been,
dude.
Yeah. That fucked. I was like, what the fuck?
And yeah, the priests are sneaky boys, dude.
I mean, dude, that's what I'm saying. Like, who wants to do that? Like,
pedophiles.
Exactly.
Yeah.
It is a hotbed for fucking pedophiles.
Yeah, so I'm just saying, like, it seems to be, like, when you get to the height of all this stuff, pedophiles get promoted.
Yes.
Because that way the people...
How do you get away with it? You run it.
That way, like, you have a fall guy. You have a face guy, like a guy that goes
Larry
out
Nassar.
There. And he's the dude that, you know, the priest is the guy that gets in trouble.
Yeah.
But what were they doing in the priest's name? Money laundering.
Yep.
You know, pretty much it's a racket. You know, they're exempt from everything.
And then they just get shuffled.
Yeah, like, people might not realize, but they lobbied hard as fuck to not have to pay taxes back in the back in the day.
Yeah.
So, I mean, they were gangsters.
They had the infrastructure to do this shit.
Yeah, they were gangsters in the 1800s, dude.
Yeah, I mean, the shit you say about Jesuits blows my mind.
Dude, look at Philadelphia and any Eastern Seaboard city. Look at how many fucking Catholic churches there are built. These are stone structures.
Big as fuck.
Big as fuck. Who the fuck do you think paid for all that?
Yeah.
You know what I mean? It's like, that's a lot. Like, think about trying to do one of those today. Big yeah. money. Big power. You know what I mean? And at the insane. Top of all that is going to be pedos, dude.
Yeah. At the top of anything that's around molding the youth, like, the wild shit you told me the one time is, the like, say a church is doing bad or a school's doing bad, the Jesuits go in there and it's just like, yo,
yeah,
here's all the cake.
Later. Peace out. Yeah.
They're like spec ops, dude.
Yep.
It is insane.
Yeah, dude. And they have a headquarters. They have like a top dog that communicates with Rome.
Yeah.
I mean, it's way beyond anything you know, you can sit there and say who runs the world and believe it's a small Israeli mob.
Yeah.
But yeah, nah, man. Yeah. You're not even coming close to the old money.
Yeah, there's a lot of players in this game. But it's like nuts. Like, I went to an all-boys school. Not gay.
I mean, little.
I'm not gay.
But a little bit more than someone that, you know.
Yeah,
definitely. Didn't do that.
Definitely, yeah. I would agree with that, yeah. But I'm not gay. Anyway, Father Bill never touched me.
Sure, man. Father Bill, I believe you, totally.
I didn't have blonde hair like 1002. 1002 had the blonde hair.
I totally buy your story.
But yeah, I mean, they're just think of something better to do. Like, I get some priests are cool. I know short guys that are cool. They're not all bad. They're not all bad. But like the Larry Nassar shit. But
they definitely don't deserve love. And if they do have it at all, they trick their way into it.
Well, here's the thing. If you're going to be a priest or a short person, like them have sex.
Well, like Kevin says, we're going to all meet up at the woods and go live in the woods.
Dude, Kevin told me that you got all you short guys have to go in the woods and all the talls get the coast.
He was killing me with that.
Yeah. But dude, like, children's gymnastics shouldn't be a thing.
No, but dude, I did it.
You did what?
Kids' gymnastics. It's fun as fuck.
It's fun, but I'm saying,
I'm not talking like organized. I'm talking like that thing.
Yeah.
You know that thing they take all the kids to now.
Sky Zone or whatever? Sky Zone, yeah. That's fun as shit. But like competitive child gymnastics, it's like, dude, where's this going? What's the end game? I mean,
you
saw
where it goes. It goes to the Olympic, the USA Olympic team.
Yes.
And the trainers of the U.S., that's the end game. They're hard.
Not worth it.
They plant the seed, they water it, and then they harvest it.
Not worth it.
I mean, yo, all you're hearing is the complaints. You're telling me that there weren't girls that got completely psyoped into thinking that they were in love with their trainers? You only saw one clip of one school.
Yeah.
This is a culture, dude.
And the weirdest part is they all get like, didn't you painted a place that was like where they held them?
Oh, yeah.
What the fuck is that? That should be a gas chamber.
Not going to disclose the location.
That should be a gas chamber.
Worried about my safety. Yeah, I was painting up a door. I was painting on a dormer and some dude rolled up and I knew him from another church we had done.
Mm-hmm.
And I was like, what the fuck's wrong with that guy? He's like 48 years old. And they're like, oh, he's sick. He's got cancer. I was like, the fuck, he's got cancer, dude? Get the fuck out of here. What'd you do?
Dude, I mean.
Nikki.
Not a curse word. That's just a fun word that we heard the other day. Can't help it, dude. That word's too good. Fuck, that word's good. Oh, yeah, but that word is so money. Oh, God damn it. Blacks are on to something. But yeah, dude, the way they just like shuffle them around, this always happens. It's like, guys, can we just reinvent the wheel? Something's obviously not working here.
I mean, the guys that run it are powerful, but they are old.
Very old.
So, I mean, sorry. I think the internet shook them all for a loop, you know, like with the whole Pizzagate thing.
Yeah.
I mean, the emails. Dude, obviously emails are forever. Wake the fuck up.
Yeah.
You know? They just didn't know what they were doing.
That internet has fucked up.
Even the Podestas are old.
Yeah.
You know, they're like 60 something, so.
I mean, like, that's what I'm saying. Like, the shit they did with, what's the girl's name? Madeline McCann?
What about her?
The, like, how they're just the sketch drawings for the people who took her.
Yeah.
It's like, they probably did that just like, yeah, whatever. I mean, fuck, it's in another country. What's that matter? It's like, yeah, and the internet exists. Here's the sketches.
Yeah, nobody thought that stuff was ever going to come global.
Yeah, I mean, these people are all getting bodied by this right now, and like they just bleach a hard drive. They're so fucked.
Yeah, it's weird, man.
I mean, it's weird that people still stand up for him.
I don't understand that. I don't understand that, and I don't understand the weird aggression of like, okay, you're a schizo, you're obsessed with pedophile rings, like they don't exist. Like the denial of their existence. Yeah. It's like, dude, you don't have to look too hard to see that the CIA was in on one. Most of the Catholic Church has different rungs of it.
Yeah.
Okay, so now we got like our Olympic sports teams. You know?
Boy
Pretty
Scouts.
Much every orphanage.
Definitely. You know, I mean, look at the Franklin scandal.
Boys Town, all that stuff, but that's every orphanage.
Yeah.
Unorganized child abuse, foster care.
Mm-hmm.
All those kids get fucked up.
Oh, yeah.
For the most part.
Yes.
There's like, it wouldn't be weird to get 10 of them in a room and be like, any of you guys, at least two hands are going up.
Yes.
That's a huge percentage to deny that it exists.
Yeah, and I mean,
you know what I mean?
On No Agenda, they were talking about how like the cartel is just like, dude, fuck drugs, we'll smuggle humans. It's more money.
Yeah, oh, yeah.
It's the most lucrative thing in the world, and you don't think evil people are going to do that instead of selling drugs?
What's at the bottom of the Getty, dude?
Good point.
I want to know what's in the basement of the Getty.
Yeah, probably a bunch of
bodies. It's weird, though. When they were going through Nevada or Arizona or whatever that was, when they were looking at the rape trees, that just disappeared, man. So you're telling me what? They found out that they were all psyoped, it was all fake, and it just went away?
Yeah.
Like, come on, man. And I got to watch Anderson Cooper has time to go do fucking clips about a guy taming a raccoon.
Yes.
You know what I mean? Like, it's fucking entertainment, dude. It's fake news.
Yeah, it really is. And like,
you see Trump's like, look at them, look at them. They're all laughing now. They might not be laughing in a couple weeks. Did you see that clip?
No.
Oh, dude, I'll play that for you.
Dude, I mean.
Oh, man.
It is insane. Like, if you sit there, because that's all I'm doing all day long is like trying to argue with people who just have the right internet on their side.
Yeah.
And it's like, dude, there's a ton of evidence. You're like, dude, look at all these articles. I have millions of articles saying that there's all. Hold on.
Publicity. Boy, they were so happy, these guys. You might not be happy in a few weeks. You know,
dude. Dude.
What a goon, dude.
Dude, you're not saying
what
these
a goon,
things.
Dude. he won't let Biden in the transition. He won't let the transition team have access to the Pentagon.
No shit. They stole an election. Like, dude, you're not like, you're Trump. Your ego is the size of this fucking room. You're not letting that be a sound clip come January against you. That's like if you had a DOS.
Good point.
You're
good
sitting
point.
There yeah. like, yeah, you'll see what happens.
I mean, I can't believe he showed his hand like that. I'd be so excited I would have done that like a week ago.
I would do it every day on Twitter, and he does. The dude does it all day. He's like, yeah, I won so much. Election fraud disputed. Election fraud disputed. Everything's disputed. AP. Associated Press.
I know. Reuters had a headline today that was like, Trump keeps up with like complete, they say like completely unfounded whatever. And I'm like sitting there going like, I mean, I don't know if you could say that at this point fairly.
Yeah, that,
you know, there's
is a disputed claim.
Yeah, it's
that's
crazy.
The right internet. That's what I'm saying. Like, that is the section of the right internet that you can be right on. All of our stuff.
Yeah, all the stuff I like is all the stuff that makes sense to me is on the opposite side.
Wrong net. That's right net. We're wrong net.
Yeah, because I'm on the other stuff. I send it to you. You don't even read it. But like I like sit there and read the people that are like, you idiot. Like this is you won't wear your mask. That's why we're all dying. You know what I mean? Like it's crazy. They're so
like how
they're so afraid. They're harvesting fear, dude.
Oh, yeah.
Like, they're doing a good job.
I mean, that's what I'm saying. Like, sometimes you can get into conspiracy theories where the reptilians harness your fear and they use it for their power source on the moon. But that's a conspiracy theory.
Yeah, or even, like, people got tricked a long time ago. Certain groups of people got tricked. They thought it was God. He said his name was Yahweh. Was a fifth density creature, dude. And enslaved a bunch of people to perform negative stuff.
Yes.
On the negative side of stuff. Hey, man, it's cool. Sometimes you get bamboozled.
Yeah, I mean, that's what I'm saying. Like, if you, like, it's constant, like, contradicting thought where it's like, yeah, fucking the science in coronavirus. Look at these death numbers. Look at these graphs. Like, okay, I'll show you a bunch of graphs that show you that the election was stolen. It's like, that's wrong. Like, okay. You literally can't win with these people.
It's crazy.
It's
crazy to survive Russiagate and then now this.
But that's what I'm saying. You have people like O'Connor.
And they are quiet, though.
Oh, yeah. Most
you know what
people.
I mean? Like, they're very, like, yeah, I mean, we want to get rid of Trump, but yeah, this is kind of weird.
Yes,
dude. Like most people, I feel like are like, yeah, it's that's because he keeps slipping up. Did you see that thing where he was like, where Biden's like, we're gonna have a fight, and then I'm gonna be sick.
Yes, that is.
Like he came out and said it. Like,
a man with dementia.
I mean, I know all about these guys, man.
Like you just don't say that as a joke, knowing like the current climate that you're in and the theories going around.
I don't think Biden has self awareness. Because when there's a slip up, when I was trying to make that one intro that was all Biden,
yeah,
he slipped up and talked about himself in the third person. So I'm thinking like he's kind of in his head. No, I think he's like kind of trapped in his own head, tripping. Hearing him, he hears himself say things that are wrong.
Yeah.
Then he laughs at himself and says like, oh, he thought this.
Yeah, he's Smeagol.
He's like talking like Smeagol. Like he's got like a shadow self because he's sitting there and he's just like, oh man, he said, no, he thought that's where we used to work. And
he
it's like,
him.
Yeah, dude. And I'm like, fuck.
He tricks his Kamala and then get out of the
And that
race.
Was like, that clip's like a year ago. That was when he was talking all big and bad about taking him in the back of the gym or whatever.
Oh, fighting
behind
Trump?
The bleachers, yeah.
You're not fighting Trump. I'm sorry. Yeah. That dude will wreck Biden.
Yeah, he's huge.
Yeah, I mean, it is wild to see all, like, every day. I get the newest fucking effort, like however effective fucking the Moderna vaccine is. And it's like, dude, Moderna isn't a vaccine company. It's a fucking cancer company that just got into vaccines. The mRNA vaccine makes more cells to fight off the bad ones. You know what happens when you get cancer?
This is why Bill giggles.
Yeah. Guess what happens when you get cancer? Yeah. Cells multiply and you get fucking tumors. This shit isn't good. You shouldn't be laughing at me because I get mad at it and saying
that's
why.
Weird how they're connected to 23andMe and all that.
It's
insane.
That's
fucking weird, dude.
The fact that they're trying to come out with specialized cancer treatment.
Yeah. I mean, dude, we can turn genes on and off. We can change people. Hey, why don't you just try to make people tall so they can find love? So that they can have hugs and kisses.
Why
does they'll deserve love?
Everyone for one.
They don't have to trick anybody.
We'll start a fund. Everyone, I know it's hard. Maybe after the lockdown, one time, 1 month, everyone just donate $10, and we'll get Spade bigger shins, and he will be 6 foot. He'll look weird, but at least he'll be 6 foot. That'll be cool.
Hey, man.
Would you do it? Actually,
I don't know. I don't
if
know.
Someone was
I mean,
like,
I did knee surgery, but I couldn't walk before that, so.
I'm just saying, like, hypothetically speaking, if someone's like, dude, everything is going to be taken care of for you, we just want to give you this surgery, try it out.
I mean, technically, that's a short trick, because then some girl's going to be with me, and then we're going to have a kid, and they're going to be like, why is he so short? I'm like,
well,
I don't
you
know,
have tall
so
jeans.
Fucking weird. Not tall, I mean.
I mean, remember what your mom said to you?
But, you know I get sad. I get sad. I thought you'd be taller. I had a hard week.
That's what I'm saying. Maybe you have tall. Maybe you can make a big U, or bigger, because you're 5'6", which is the average height for a fucking U.S. male.
Yeah, and I told you, average dick size is what 5.5 inches. But go ask a girl if that's enough.
I hear you.
It's the same. We're in the same boat here, man.
But I mean, yeah. It makes you feel better.
Because the internet said it.
Because our internet
is it, what does Reuters say it?
My internet says the common dick size is 3 inches. I'm huge, bro. Yeah, I mean, it is crazy that everyone's like lining up for this. Like, I will take it if it means going back. It's like Shane's hair pills. It's like Shane reads it and it's like, oh, it'll make you impotent. You won't be able to have kids. I got fuck that. But like these people are like, I mean, we'll see what happens. If I don't have coronavirus anymore, at least I can go to see a concert and go out and have fun. We can get through with all this.
Like, yeah.
This is children of men.
I know.
This is 1,000,000,000% children of men.
Programming.
Yes.
You know, that's why I get fired up when Rogies goes on Jones and he's like, my problem is like you all look back at this in hindsight. It's like, no, dude, you do.
Yes.
We're saying it and we're crackpots.
Yes.
And 5 years later, you're like, holy shit. They were already talking about normalizing pedophilia.
Yes, that was in 2016, that picture.
And now what, dude, show somebody from 2012 what the fuck HBO Max looks like right now. They're not going to know what planet they're on. Transhood, dude?
What?
Yeah, it's a show just about how kids transing. It's cool.
Dude.
Hey, man, you want to watch something? We'll take a break. We'll
There's
watch
not that many transsexual dude, humans on the
they
planet.
They have to hit the market.
There's no fucking market.
They gotta hit the market, dude.
There's not enough fucking market. Unless you trick people into thinking it's powerful and cool. It's such a fucking small percentage of people.
And Reddit, I know what you're trying to do to me in the morning.
Tinder's fucking with
enough,
you, too.
Enough. Yeah. Danny, you're not. You'll never be a woman. You have no ovaries. You have no womb.
That is.
How did we even match? Enough.
Stop going.
Amber, why don't you text me back?
Stop going into his search history.
I thought we were getting pierogies and you just totally ghosted me again. God damn it. I thought you loved Jesus.
Yeah, I mean.
How can I trick her?
Yeah, you gotta start a cult. Yeah, it is just crazy that they're pushing this stuff. It's like, dude.
Yeah, man.
You tricked everyone into it. It's the same shit with anti-vaxxers, the slow. I remember sitting there getting blood red mad watching Vice about like, oh, well, these people know they're a woman. They're 12 years old. They know they're a girl. So we help them because their parents are bigots. It's like, no, dude, their parents know what's best for them because you destroy someone's life. You're not going to give a 12-year-old steroids to get big.
But
let
all this
grow up.
I'm telling you, dude, all of this stuff goes down to mental health. Zappa used to talk about this shit.
Yes.
This shit falls apart because the parents are so fucking weird and insecure and narcissistic that they use their kids as virtue signals.
Yeah.
Imagine
I mean, look
caring,
at all the freaks in West Philly that adopt black kids.
Imagine, that's kind of weird that you said that.
it's a wild virtue signal.
It's cool, dude. I mean, my sister's Korean.
Your dad.
Sometimes you can't have
your dad's
kids,
such a virtue signal.
I mean, at least my dad had the decency not to care about us.
Yeah.
But yeah, like it's weird to think that a parent would care more about themselves and how they appear to other parents than their own kid's health and yeah. mental health.
Yes, it literally makes zero sense, and it's all from. The shit you look at on the internet.
I'd be jammed if I was a kid and this shit was out there. I mean, you can't in one hand say that psychological warfare works and also at the same time think that this doesn't have an effect on kids.
Yeah, it's destroying them.
I mean, it's a chicken and the egg. If you watch enough of these smutty fucking cartoons and these weird-ass transhood shows, your kid's going to be weird.
I mean, dude, fucking... My cousin's wife said that her kid asked for a black baby doll for equality.
For how old's a kid? How old's a kid?
Young, like we dude. It's like, dude, they're catching up on this shit. Like they're gonna. This is gonna be the weirdest.
I mean,
batch.
I saw you know how I love Tolkien.
Yeah.
And they're putting.
Oh, they're
putting
yeah.
boobs in.
Lord of the Rings
cool,
got
dude.
Blacked.
Yeah, fucking black dudes in somehow. But, I mean, are they going to be from Middle Earth? Are they the men of the East? Like, I just want to know, like, are you going to give them a backstory? Or are we just going to pretend black dudes are now in Middle Earth? And they have been the whole time. I just want to know what the rules are, man.
Are you going to watch Lord of the Rings?
Huh? Yeah. I mean, I love it.
Okay.
I mean, I watched the bad Star Wars, dude. Oh, dude, don't even get me started on fucking Mando.
Why?
So good. God, so good.
You make me want to watch it, but at the same time, I
fucking
don't want
Grogu,
to download Disney.
Grogu, you're just chilling on the fucking seeing stone, dude. Tapping into the Force.
I really don't feel like downloading Disney Plus.
Yeah. Well, I mean, there's ways to get it. You can just rip it off. I don't know how to do it.
You've never done it.
I'm not a computer guy, no.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't know. The fact that
I have to ditch my phone. My phone's fried.
Yeah.
My phone's fucked up from trying to do all these fucking intros, so I'm done. I'm done for now because I'm gonna have to delete all this shit.
I'm telling you, just take my laptop.
I don't know how to use it, dude.
You can figure it out.
Well,
you're not dumb.
I might get. What about that one Matt bought us?
It's down there.
I'll try
that.
I'll try that one.
I'm not gonna
take your MacBook, dude.
I don't even care, dude. Fuck it.
I don't want to have that thing in my house, man.
Yeah. Yeah, what happened? I thought you were going to play Undertaker getting fucked up by Stone Cold on the intro. What did you do?
Dude,
I'm sorry, I ruined your YouTube.
I just wanted to play the Jones thing. You were really holding back some of the funniest shit about yourself last week.
What?
I remember you were talking about all you being a goofball when you're little.
Yeah.
You totally didn't tell everybody about how you cried when Stone Cold died, dude. Which is one of the funniest stories of all time.
It doesn't fucking matter, dude. Dude, wrestling was fucking everything when I was little.
Yeah, well, it's everything right now.
It took like 4 years for me to figure out Godzilla wasn't real. And then I got hit with wrestling. And then I had to figure out, like, when I was getting on wrestling.
I told you yesterday that you live in a world of lies and psyops with your family.
Yes.
Backed up by autism.
Yeah.
I was telling Matt about this, and he says that you're being crushed into an autistic diamond by the forces above you. Like, yes, the generations ahead of you, yes, are just putting so much pressure on you, dude.
Mm-hmm. I mean, dude, you go through Godzilla, figure out he isn't real. Then in between time, figure out Santa isn't real. No big deal, honestly.
Spoiler alert, chill.
One of the goat
things. If you're little and listening, dude, Billy's just joking around.
One of the goat things to do in fourth grade, they start talking about Santa. Oh, yeah.
fucking morons.
That's why my mom got me an electric scooter.
You don't even understand because you're like the youngest dude.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, I was by myself.
Oh my god, dude. Yeah. That was probably insane.
Oh, it was a fucking nightmare.
Like, when did you figure out Santa wasn't real?
I just slowly figured it out.
How?
I don't know. I mean, I don't remember like an exact moment, but I remember being like, I remember thinking that I was not cool because I totally did not know that.
Yeah, that's,
I remember like getting hit with like, "You're a faggot, dude." Like, I thought Santa was still real. I was like, "Yeah, totally." And then like, not only am I a fag, but I'm also very sad now because Santa's not real.
Yeah, that's a hard pill to swallow. And obviously, once you figure out he's real, just be like, "Yeah, I fucking knew for like 2 years, dude. I figured out like second grade." And then the other horrible lie that I would just do constantly. You didn't have older brothers, so
yeah,
this wasn't a competition. When you first kissed a girl. Dude, there's so many chicks that didn't exist that I hooked up with from like fifth to eighth grade.
Yeah, I mean, we had Sev.
Yeah. Well, that was a whole different fucking scenario.
It's another world of autistic ball tapping.
Dude.
Where like you guys live in this weird like
hierarchy. All four of us was.
It's a weird hierarchy that only you guys participate in.
Yeah.
Where like it doesn't make any difference.
Yes. I know. Understand that I was in sixth grade and it was a bedroom, like almost like a fucking jail. It. My bed, Matt's bed, Kevin's bed, Tom's bed, all lined up against the wall, pitch black. And you got however old you got, you're 10 years older than me. And everyone's asking me about shit and I'm trying to answer it. Just constant psyops in the dark.
Yeah, man. You were tortured.
Yes.
This is what happens at Gitmo.
Yes. But yeah, I mean, figuring out wrestling wasn't real fucked me up, dude.
Yeah, well, Stone Cold is still with us.
He is. He's a fucking...
We've lost a lot of wrestlers, though, from that era.
Who's the one who jumped off the cage and fucking broke his neck? Bret Hart?
Yeah, Bret Hart, one of the Hearts.
Hells in the Cells used to scare the fuck out of me.
Yeah, in looking for that clip, I found, like, how Stone Cold used to be able to do, like, the rattlesnake neck.
Yeah.
And then one of the Hearts broke his neck.
Yeah.
On stage. Like, on in the ring. Like, on TV.
One of the Hearts broke the Undertaker's neck?
Stone Cold's.
Oh, yeah. So they're all like,
he pops up and just goes like this to the camera.
Yeah.
And like everyone, no one has any clue. And Stone Cold's like laying on the ground. And he told him, he's like, "Yo, I'm fucked up." It's wild to watch. You watch him get his neck broke. And then since then, he tries to do like the head thing and he can't move his neck.
I mean, dude, Austin 316.
I'll throw those clips. I have to cut all the clips out. I'm saving them for I'm saving all my black ones. Like,
yeah.
What are you gonna do about it, Whitey? Yeah, I'm saving all that for like a Superfly one.
My level of dickheadedness came from Stone Cold Steve Austin, giving someone the finger and spearing them. Stone Cold Steve Austin, spearing people in general. Stone Cold Steve Austin.
Yeah, yeah.
Fucking also very dangerous to do to people. Stunners.
Yeah.
Fuck people up. And I did it. Kick someone in the balls and grab their neck and drop down, dude. That shit is terrifying.
Oh, man.
Yeah, the only fucking wrestler I ever met was Goldberg. It's like Stone Cold on some
you
boxing.
You met Goldberg?
Fuck yeah, dude. I was like first grade. He fucking did a bicep, like showed off his bicep, and I just hung off. I was like, yo. Yeah, we went to some like weird ass place. It was me and my one buddy. We went there into a monster truck rally, and one day it was like some of the coolest shit I've ever done.
Good memories, dude.
This kid loved Goldberg so much so that we were in kindergarten, and he was wild. Like, the kid was out of his fucking skull. Pulled his pants down and showed his fucking Goldberg underwear and started smacking his ass going, woo!
Dude. But yeah, my brother got into monster trucks for a while. He was a big Gravedigger head.
Yeah, Gravedigger's a goat. Yeah, I was like obsessed with Red. I had all the action figures, all that shit. And then one time I was climbing up on my fucking top bunk because I shared a bunk bed for a while with my sister. She scared me, and then I just completely fell back onto the ring, smashed everything. Then I got into skateboarding.
Yeah, my wrestling ended like early.
Did you guys get into wrestling?
Yeah, we had the heyday of wrestling.
Yeah, I mean, I thought ours.
Yeah, like, yeah, I mean, you probably think yours was, but
who'd you have?
Hulk Hogan, Andre the Giant.
Yeah, I mean, yeah. That's good.
Yeah.
I mean, when you start talking about ECW,
that was like
D-Generation X.
I was still cool then.
Yeah, that's me, dude.
Yeah, you were little though.
I mean, D-Generation X was the coolest.
I'm just saying, if you started the wrestling timeline like with Hulk,
yeah,
and then you end it with
D-Generation X, yeah,
The Rock, Hell in the Cell, Mankind. I mean, that's a pretty good wrestling
SmackDown
career.
SmackDown vs.
Raw. I mean, when did yours end? When did you stop wrestling? What's notable?
Fuck.
Yeah, not that memorable, dude.
Yeah, good point. Probably in like 2001.
D-Generation X was like when I was like 13, and I was like, yeah, wrestling's fake, and I'm still watching it with my little. I had a little brother.
Yeah.
So I was know, like, I yeah, that. Just put it on for him.
I remember tuning in, just being like, I wonder if he pulls it off this week. Yeah,
and the N64 game was the shit.
Royal Rumble?
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, that was amazing. I remember playing that Y2K when it was turned in 2000, dude. We played that all night long in the basement. It was just the fucking coolest shit in the world.
Yeah, it's nice, dude.
Nintendo 64.
Get some sodas, play some fucking WrestleMania, dude.
Dude, I can't like ever wrap my head around the amount of sodas I drank. While like, if I tried to put that, I could put down more beer currently than I could the amount of soda I did when I was like 8.
Yeah, me and Fed were talking about, like, little kids eating and then getting jammed, like.
Yeah, I would just get a headache.
Yeah, and it's like, I used to, like, I would, like, rip ice cream and then drink, like, 5 Cokes and then wonder why I just had diarrhea. Just be like, oh, my God, I'm dying.
I mean, didn't like, you, did dude, you do shit the yourself in math. Second grade at your communion?
Yeah, but I'm just saying, like, do the math, bud. Like, this doesn't mix.
Yeah, you're making a float in your stomach and it's going to shoot out your ass.
Yeah.
Yeah, that
like a farting wombat.
I don't understand how I used to drink that soda, dude. And like if we had a party at my parents' house, there would be after the party, like the soda would just go in their fridge in the basement, and I would walk down there before dinner. Like we never had soda at dinner. It was just like water, that's it. Like nothing. We never all had like a 2-liter. I would open the cellar doors, go downstairs and put my hand over it and just go and just sip. Chug a Pepsi. And go back upstairs, dude. Mouth tasting like change. Like,
trying
to crush mashed potatoes and beef still.
Jesus Christ, dude.
Oh my God, dude. Yeah. Fucking. What the fuck else was I going to tell you? Nothing. I'll save the Sev story for the Patreon because that is top tier funny shit. Sev's story is the origins of why they call
Sev's me. Sev's like when I remember you as an adult.
Yeah, well, yeah.
Like, I like hadn't heard of you in years.
Yeah.
And then they're like, wait till you hear what Billy's up to.
Yeah. Yeah, that was like 8th grade. Oh, that, yeah, that was 8th grade. One.
I want to say from the time you were like in 4th grade to 8th grade, I never fucked
yeah,
around.
I mean, I was just playing sports, listening to like rap and shit.
Yeah.
I was like figuring out how to download MP3s. I had this weird little MP3 player that was like an up and down on the side before the iPod.
Like a Rune thing?
They weren't Runes. I forget what they're called. I think Walkman made them.
Swag.
Or you downloaded it all on RealPlayer before iTunes came out. But like, yeah, that's all I was doing was playing like Summer League basketball, all that shit. And then like I unlocked the fact that you can get Sniz. And I was like, why am I such a loser? Why am I in 7th grade on useless junk watching chicks give blowjobs to dogs? And I literally haven't even kissed a girl yet. Why is this a thing? So I was jammed, and then 8th grade, I finally hooked up with a chick at St. Kev's Dance.
Yeah, I mean, that's cool. I mean, it is what it is, dude. You're definitely not a loser if you don't get any sense. It's like,
I mean,
you know, if you're, like, laying in bed and you're watching, like, The Crown on Netflix or something, and you're, like, thinking back about all your old girlfriends, and, like, you kind of had a Princess Di Charles thing going on, maybe, who knows?
You're Charles?
I mean, who knows, dude? Am I a prince? Who knows?
I mean, yeah, there's no height requirement for a prince, dude.
You're just kind of born into it. They don't really breed smalls, though.
Yeah, they probably kill guys like you.
Pretty much. Yeah, they actually put
little wombats.
They put the retard. They put retards in a home.
Yeah, dude, and they just
and they just left them there.
Yes.
I mean, maybe we should go to the woods. Just put us in the woods. We'll probably be happier with our own kind.
Yeah, it is crazy.
Hearing the way people really talk about you when you're not around.
Yeah.
And you know that there's a short in the room.
Yeah.
Real Selma moment there for Lemaire.
Yeah.
You know, Lemaire, you would have got a hose, bud. You would have got rubber bullets, bud.
Yeah. And the fact that he didn't stand up
for didn't stand up for our people.
I mean, real, same size.
A real Kuhn moment.
Yeah. Same size.
Yeah, like, you got to please master. I understand.
You can, I mean, yeah. It is crazy. I mean, you're literally just born that way.
I know, and you can't do anything about it.
It's not like you're a fat bastard just being a slob. It's just you fucking popped out of a pussy. You grew a little bit, and then you stopped.
You grew a little bit, and in eighth grade, you're done.
You're like, damn.
And it's just like, and then you get, you're tricking people, and you have to be alone, because they want to feel safe. I mean, hey, man.
Yeah, the internet, all you have to do is just crush the gym, dude. Do steroids. Do steroids and just unit the fuck out. Have, like, yellow eyes all the time. Your liver's fucked.
Yeah, let me get all kinds of damage in my body so I can feel love.
I get so confused. I would, like, go to job sites.
Let me get hugs and kisses, please.
When I was, like, 20, 21, and, like, there'd be, like, just, like, roided out steam fitters. And the dude literally was on so many roids that his eyes were just beet yellow. He looked like he was from fucking, like, sub-Saharan Africa. And he just looked.
What did they do to you?
They fucking destroy your insides.
No, I mean, like, if you take them, like, what do you feel like?
I don't fucking know.
Like, does it make you feel strong?
I guess you get stronger. I guess you recover faster, which makes you able to lift more. I don't fucking know. But this
dude, I'm just saying, like, some days you have a little pep in your step.
Yeah.
You got a little dip on your chip. You're walking up the steps and you're like, I feel young today.
Yeah.
Like, is that what steroids are?
I guess, dude. Like, this dude was so jammed on steroids that he would blink slow. Like, I could watch him blink and unblink. Like, it looked like he was falling asleep in real time in front of me.
You gotta get the gains.
But he's just telling me a story. It's like, to do what, dude? Like,
you get addicted to them? Like,
I would assume you can't lift without them. You're like, talking to Natch.
I saw Triple H. I saw what happened to his bod.
It get fucked up, dude.
Like, once you're on them, you have to. If you get big on them, you gotta stay on them. Or you get, like,
you get
what you have, your mess, it just kind of fucking melts. You look like you're melting.
Yeah, I mean, I feel like it's a type of thing where if you take them and you get to that level of the mountain and then you try to go off of them, you just get fucking flabby and nasty.
Yeah, because you have all this, like, body.
You can't work that hard.
Right, you can't keep up with your own size.
Yes.
That's the problem.
I mean, it definitely, from the people I know and shit that have done it, it's like, dude, why? Like, what is the point of this? If you're like,
they want to bulk up their air suit, dude. They're not happy with what God gave them, which is kind of weird.
Yeah, I mean, if you're climbing up and down ladders all day and you're an electrician, why do you need to be that big?
That's crazy.
It just doesn't make sense. It's like you're fucking huge for no reason.
It's a pain in the ass to be big.
Yeah, like you can't like reach behind your back and shit.
It's kind of sweet being little. You can do all kinds of stuff. It's just
no one's ever going to have to ask you to bend down and grab that, you know?
Yeah, socially, you never hit your head. Like, I never hit my head.
You're probably a beast in basements.
Oh, yeah.
Every basement's tall to you.
I almost never have to watch out for getting bumped in my head.
Kind of legendary, dude. I mean,
it's pretty sweet.
You heard Jones talk about air suits.
Jones is short.
Rogan's 5'8".
Allegedly.
I mean, that dude is all of 5'2.5". You're not telling me that guy's
not
5'.
Not that it matters, dude.
You're not telling me that guy's 5'. Rogan is a unit.
He's a bit. He's a thick boy.
He's a can of fucking soup with arms.
Yeah, him on Jones is cracking me up. Got drunk as fuck.
He gets drunk and so girly.
Yeah, it's a difference between for him drinking. He's drinking a lot because he can't smoke weed.
Well, they were smoking weed.
Yeah, I mean, but I'm saying, like, for the most part, I feel like he's like,
I
just got 100 mil.
Yeah,
they're like, yo, dude, you can't really be like ripping these J's on camera anymore. So yeah. He's like, yeah, I'll just have a double, but like alcohol is so dangerous, dude. It's a slippery slope.
Yeah, I just
before like you're like, oh, yeah, look, get another one, get another one, get another one.
Well, he literally said that. Yeah, he was like, oh yeah, man, dude, these things are going down fast. It's like, yeah, Rogan, you're talking about fucking Bill Gates instead of killing him. Because that wouldn't be as bad.
Yeah, your face will get all blown out if you drink that much whiskey.
Oh yeah,
it's like, dude, you get like inflated, like I you don't even recognize people. Yourself, and you're all fucking hammered
just
all the time.
Red as shit.
Yeah, you're always hammered.
I just want to know what they do after it's over. It's like, are you getting Ubers? You guys just bossing a fucking whip back to your house?
They're probably bossing whips, dude. They're loaded.
That's insane,
dude. People still drink and drive.
We don't. Guy like
we
me.
We don't.
Yeah, I've only done that like once, and I fucking think about it all the time and cringe.
Yeah, dude.
I went up 202. Like this is the easiest way to get back to Westchester. I was just drunk. I was like fucking 20.
Yeah, I mean, if people knew what I did, they'd want me in jail. They'd want me locked up.
Like, cock as fuck, pulled through Taco Bell. Like, give me a cheesy gordita crunch, please, and a quesadilla, and a Baja Blast please, Mountain Dew.
Please,
thank you.
Dilla, please.
Yeah, that, I fucking cringe about that constantly. But yeah, we're going to go over to Patreon. Talk about
you good?
Yeah, talk about Sev.